This talk is about my philosophy of back pain management. This is a personal experience. The incident happened in 2007 when I was in prison, when I had a sudden onset backache. The pain was debilitating, SLR was 20 degrees, I had a severe hamstring spasm and sciatic scoliosis. I'm an orthopedic surgeon and I operated on hundreds of discs in my past. Gradually, my EHL became weak. On the third day, I got a foot drop. On the fifth day, I got urinary incontinence. Then I had urinary retention. I had to self-catheterize myself. Unfortunately, I was in a very primitive prison with no facilities. There was no doctor, no medicines, no x-rays. As I was the only doctor around, I had to treat myself. My philosophy for back pain sciatica emerged from within the confines of the prison. I recovered fully in 3 weeks. Today, my EHL is 5.5. I can stand tiptoes and run upstairs effortlessly. I can stand hours performing surgery. I then began studying patients with backaches in prison. And on that, I did a 10-year study. By luck, I had an opportunity to monitor and study a group of 67 patients with CT or MRI prone prolapsed intervertebral discs treated by various means and could study them for periods up to 13 years with an average follow-up of 10 years. The inclusion criteria was simple: MRI proven single or multiple level prolapse with nerve or root impingement, patients with persistent symptoms, pain, some amount of neurological deficit, SLR below 40 degrees, patients who were convict prisoners and could be closely followed up for at least 7 years or more. As we can see from the chart, these were young men from 20 to around 50, 55, all males because I was in a male prison, and the total number of patients, as you see, were around 60s. Around 19 patients had surgeries before they entered the prison, 14 had epidural injections, while 34 were treated with painkillers, physiotherapy and exercises. All operative cases were operated by orthopedic or neurosurgeons outside the prison. Conservative group was treated either by me or have taken no treatment. At the end of 10 years, we did an evaluation of the three groups: no treatment, injection treatment, and operation by three standard parameters: Auschwitz 3 rating scale, visual analog scale, and visual rating scale. And surprise, surprise, there was no difference between epidural injection and no treatment. And surgery gave the worst results with permanent complications in 19% of the patients. I have to point out this stage that none of these patients had the minimally invasive surgery like what we are discussing in the conference over the last 2 days. They had proper open laminectomies or discectomies. And close to 19% of patients at the end of 10 years had some form of complication or the other. So, I learnt a moral that never operate on a prolapsed disc, because even those with neurological deficit or bladder problems get well after some time. On analyzing the literature, I found that yes, there were a few studies which supported my view, like the Cochrane review for surgery of lumbar disc prolapse and degenerative lumbar spondylosis, and a spine article in 2011. Now that I know about distal sodium channel block, it is unlikely if I would operate on any disc again. This short video shows the L4 and L5 distal sodium channel block on a patient with low backache, severe sciatica, SLR of 10 degrees. He was brought to my clinic. He is my butcher who supplies meat to my dogs, and he was brought to my home on a Sunday with two people assisting him and supporting him to even take a few steps. His SLR was just 10 degrees. He had very marked hamstring spasm and was in agony. We can see that I am administering an L5 block, which is 4 to 5 centimeter below the knee joint crease, and I am injecting Chennai cocktail 4 milliliters in 15 minutes of the injection. We can see that the patient is independently mobile, though with the limp. His pain is almost disappearing, and he has a rather big smile on his face. He came to me the evening to deliver the meat, and you can see that this man was in agony and was advised hospitalization by another surgeon. Is rather normal and back to work, and in him the single injection was enough, and he never needed to miss a day of work. My current backache protocol is to give oral steroids, high dose Metoprolol 8 mg 3 times daily, 6 doses only. I routinely deworm my patients with albendazole or etrazole. I give strong anti-inflammatory and painkillers like indomethacin. I give a distal sodium channel block with Chennai cocktail. Advise lifestyle changes, weight reduction, yoga, exercises, and most importantly, aggressive physiotherapy. And I am happy to inform you that almost all my patients have avoided the knife, whether open or minimally invasive. So much so that in jest, I often put this slide in my talks, that the principal indications of disc surgery would be holiday for the surgeon and his spouse, college admission for the surgeon's son, a new car or a holiday home, or possibly even a speedboat if our surgeon friend operates on every back. And thus, I have devised what I call a scrotocerebral index, or a balls over brains ratio. While our testosterone urges us to rush into surgery, cerebral serotonin urges us extreme caution. We, as orthopedic scientists, must make our choices wisely. The carry-home message from this talk is that we must not try to achieve competition with nature, or we must not try to bypass nature. We must try to achieve synergy with nature, assisting nature in natural healing. Thank you very much for your kind interest. And this slide shows all my exotic pets, 40 of them, with whom I live in South India. Thank you once again for your patient attention. Thank you.